Welcome back to The Nest. My name is Maureen Waititu, your host. On 2nd of April, we'll mark the World Autism Day. It is a day that marks neurological developmental issues, mostly in children. Are we failing as a country to bring these neurological developmental matters to a day of awareness? Is it just a paper that is signed for PR? But just imagine a parent who hasn't had one but two children who she's raising on her own who have autism and a different neurological development disorder. She has an incredible story. Not only has she overcome a lot of these difficulties, but she's decided to become a voice of matters autism with her organization. I cannot wait to hear her story, and I'm sure neither can you. And so let's have a seat and meet her.
Autism is a neurodevelopmental disorder that impairs social skills, communication deficits, and interfering repetitive behavior. Intellectual disability often accompanies autism. Autism spectrum disorder impacts the nervous system. Research shows that autism does occur more often in boys than girls, with a 4-to-1 male-to-female ratio. Autism symptoms typically become clearly evident during early childhood between 12 and 24 months of age. However, symptoms may also appear earlier or later. Early recognition, as well as behavioral, educational, and family therapies, may reduce symptoms and support development and learning. Some of the symptoms of this disorder include repetitive behaviors like hand flapping, rocking, or jumping, hyperbehavior. Fixations on certain activities or objects and being fixed to routine to the point of getting upset when a routine is changed, even slightly. Extreme sensitivity to touch, light, and sound. Autism is caused by genetics or environmental influences. As the world commemorates World Autism Day on 2nd April, our motive is to raise awareness on this condition.
Today's guest is a wonderful woman, a drop-dead gorgeous woman, a beauty queen, a queen mother of three lovely boys, and she is very passionate about all matters autism, and I cannot wait, in her own words, for her to tell us what she's all about, and I will not waste another minute, and I'm going to introduce Sylvia. Kindly tell us all the crowns you wear, because I hear there are quite many. Who are you?
Okay, Sylvia is my name, Sylvia Moramo Chabo. Yes. I'm a mother of three.
Wow.
Who I have raised single-handedly, and I'm very proud of that. I'm a divorcee.
Uh-huh.
And on top of that, I'm a businesswoman. Mm-hmm. I have my own company called Tech Hub Holdings, mm-hmm. which is in graphic design, branding, and events management.
Nice.
And then I run a foundation for uh-huh. championing for persons with neurodevelopmental disabilities.
Yes.
Because of my three boys, two mm-hmm. of them are autistic. One has autism, the other one has ADHD.
Okay.
And this has been an experience, to say the least.
Yes.
I sit in the board for Sense International.
Okay.
I am the patron for Makadara Sub County Scouts.
Wow.
I like you said, I am the reigning queen.
Yes.
I am currently reigning as Miss Africa Elite 2020-2021,
mm-hmm.
Miss Africa United Nations 2020-2021,
wow.
and Elite Face of Africa 2020-2021.
Gosh.
COVID extended my reign for another
Absolutely.
One year. So I'm like, it's okay. It's
See
fine.
How God
I'll
works.
Take it. Yes.
I got goosebumps as uh-huh. you kept introducing yourself, and I can't help but notice what a strong woman you are, and you keep yourself together, and you raise these boys, and you run all these things. Indeed, women do run the world, and
we
I've
do.
Just met one.
We do run the world. Yes.
Karibu sana.
Thank you very much.
Yes.
Yeah, and also to top it up, on Friday yes. I was awarded as the first runners-up for National Inclusion and Diversity Individual Champion. So yeah, that was another jewel on my crown.
Yes,
I am a Zuri nominee. Wow. And also top women in business, mm-hmm. In CSR. Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
I cannot, you guys, I'm in the presence of everything powerful, everything good, and I'm really, really honored that you could, you know, honor our humble request to have you on board so that we can speak about autism today.
Yeah.
And as a mother myself, you can imagine when you're experiencing the journey, all you're praying for is a healthy baby.
Yes.
And you do everything you can to make sure that the baby comes to the world and they're healthy. But these things are unexpected.
Yeah.
And then what and how do you jump the hurdle? And I'd love to hear your story from, you know, the journey of motherhood, from the day you got your firstborn, when you got your secondborn and maybe noticed, oh, something is off. Could you walk us through that?
I had my firstborn when I was 22, I think, thereabout. I'm an early bloomer in everything.
Yes.
That's everything.
Way to go.
So I was a bouncing baby boy. I tell you, I was first scared. You know when you get pregnant the first time, we always have our scares. For me, my phobia was stretch marks.
Yes.
And sorry to say this, but I'm like, I'm light skin. Yes. I want a light baby. And I'm like, okay. So. I'm being very brutally honest.
No. This is a very safe space.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So, okay, yes. God had me at least. I don't have stretch marks. He's an intelligent, awesome human being.
Oh, wow.
Yes, he has grown to be a man, the man of the house.
Wow.
We've walked this journey together. Mm-hmm. He's been my pillar and support system in raising his two brothers because going through a divorce and special needs kids, you can't go at it alone.
Absolutely.
And most of the time, sadly, you find yourself in a cocoon by yourself.
Yeah.
So he's been a pillar in my life.
Oh.
He's called Daniel. So
bless
I always
him.
Say, like, yes,
yes,
this den of lions I'm in, he walks me out.
I was just thinking of the same thing.
Yes.
Yes.
And then my second born is called Andrew, after my dad.
Oh.
And Andrew came, and he's beautiful. He's a boy, but he's beautiful.
Yes.
Guys
know what
to
you
tell
mean.
Me, like, yeah.
Pretty boy.
Yes, he's a pretty boy. They're like, why are you putting lipstick on him? I'm like, dude.
No, he doesn't
have
any lipstick.
That's how gorgeous he is. And him, he now came out.
Yes.
When I wanted light, now he's Uko.
Whoa. Uh-huh.
So he was like, an awesome child, you know, the child you want. But I was working, being a workaholic, when I delivered him a bit early, because I was handling a very tough project at the time, and I think that also caused a lot of complications for me. Although the pregnancy had been smooth, I had my evening sickness.
Okay.
I had evening sickness.
Interesting.
Yeah, I actually had to drop out from, I was doing evening classes.
Okay.
I had to stop,
because
my nausea used to come at like 5. You leave work and your system can't just function.
That is interesting.
Yes.
Okay.
So every child is different.
Yes.
And then I was craving water. I always laugh at that. I would finish a whole Del Monte and quarter chicken and fries
alone. Gosh.
Like, don't mess with this.
No way.
So the bath, I just, my water's drained.
Okay.
You know, I had not experienced water breakage because even for my firstborn, they had to break the water.
Of course.
Yeah.
Yes.
So I had no experience of that.
Uh-huh.
So I just signed off the project.
Okay.
Then when I stood up, I'm like, I see a spot. I'm not supposed to have a spot. So I just went and pulled my boss lady.
Yes.
And I'm like, I think there's something. So she came. She was like, okay, it's not a lot, but let's call the doctor.
Yes.
So doctor says, come, we need to do a scan and check like how much of it has.
Yes.
Because I have no experience, like, is it supposed to be a lot? You know, in movies there are things you see and you're always
that
like
the water breaks, like
yeah, it's like a girl shaft. So
yes.
I'm questioning, like, okay, is something right, wrong, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So then the doctor, so of course at that time I was still married. So I called hubby and I'm like, hey, you need to come pick me from work, because it was around 7.
Yes.
And we need to go straight to the doctor.
Uh-huh.
So pick me, we went. Okay. Then they were like, no, we have to keep you.
Mm-hmm.
And we did the scan. They were like, yeah, the water has drained, but let's see within the week, because it was at week 37 there about.
Oh, yes,
36.
I was going to ask,
week 36.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So they were like, let's give it some time, because
it
was just starting. So until we clock 36 like this, then we make a decision.
But there's no labor at this point?
No, at this point there was no labor, just the water.
Okay.
So after that, I was like, okay, Saba, let's do this.
Right.
Waited whole week. No improvement in the liquids.
No.
So they were like, okay, let's just inject with that oxygen thing to make his lungs able
stronger.
To breathe.
Yes.
So we get him out. I was like, okay, fine.
Mm-hmm.
Then now they induced me.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing.
No.
Second induction. It was now, it came like the labor pains.
Yes.
Then it disappeared. Third induction. They were like, I was not dilating.
Yes.
I was stuck at 3 centimeters.
Yes.
So they were like, okay, let's try third and final. After okay. this, we have to think otherwise. So okay. I mean, this is over days. And that pain yes. was ooh, intense.
I can imagine.
You know?
Yes.
So it was like, it's here. Then it disappears. Mm-hmm. So they were like, okay, guys, we have to go to theater.
So how long is this?
This is like, a from whole the week. Imagine. No. As in, it was a week. Like, we waited like 3 days. The waters no. didn't come. Uh-huh. So another, because I remember mm-hmm. it was what, we, on Friday. Mm-hmm. On Friday evening.
Yes.
Because they were like, I know we have to get this baby out now.
Yes.
Because they were checking. And you know how uncomfortable it is oof. Being checked by yeah. different people every other time. Mm. And I'm like, I can't.
The thought of going back there.
No.
Yes.
But anyway, mm-hmm. it's called the experience of yes. giving, yes. You know, life.
Yes.
So time came and I was really into CS. Mm-hmm. They refused for my ex-husband to come in.
Okay.
I went in. Uh-huh. I just remember them counting. I knocked off.
Oh.
And I woke up.
Uh-huh.
I think like the next day at around midday. That's oh. how long I was knocked out.
Okay.
For.
So what time did they knock you out?
At like 6 p.m.
Oh, and you woke up the following day?
The next day at like 11. Because I remember what? My dad came. That means it was visiting hours.
Yes, yes.
So the first thing I was like, how's my baby? They yes. said, he's fine.
Uh-huh.
You know, but then yes. there is a way you're told oh, and no. you're like, okay.
I know, a maternal you know? Instinct is yeah. never
like,
wrong.
Okay. So when my ex was like, is everything okay? He's like, not sure he's in an incubator.
Uh-huh.
And the way they rushed out, because uh-huh. they rushed out with him, I wasn't even able to see him.
Yes.
But I've seen him after they've set him
yes.
up. So he had been put on oxygen and stuff
oh,
like
I
that.
Oh, I see. Uh-huh.
So I was like, okay, mm-hmm. fine. Mm-hmm. Can I go see him?
Mm-hmm.
They were like, yeah, sure. Then I tried to stand and my whole world went black.
Oh my.
So I was reacting to the anesthesia.
No way.
My heart rate went up. I couldn't move. So they had to sedate me again.
What?
I remember my dad had come.
Uh-huh.
So I just told my, when I woke up again,
mm-hmm.
they weren't understanding what
mm-hmm.
was going
mm-hmm.
on. So I told my ex, please go take a photo. At
yes.
least I see.
Yes.
So I was like,
yes.
oh, he's so tiny.
Yes.
You know, the way they come out so wrinkled and
yes.
stuff like that.
Yes.
Okay, so cute and uh-huh. tiny.
Yes.
Then I was like, please, may I hold him? They were like, okay, Sawa, let me bring.
Mm-hmm.
So they brought him out.
Okay.
Then after a while,
mm-hmm.
They didn't actually he didn't get to me. They were like, I'm sorry, but we can't get him out because he started turning purple.
Oh no.
So they put him back.
Okay.
So now I had to gather all my strength
uh-huh.
and my dad was there, then I had to go and see him.
Okay.
And you know, after CS it's I always say I'd rather
yeah.
normal any
yes.
day. CS
yes.
is
yes.
drama.
Yes.
Because the pain, you know, you forget. You're used to your normal
oh,
body.
No.
So of course you are cut and you're like
oh, yes,
everything
incredible
is,
pain.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So I went to see my baby, I'm
mm-hmm.
like, okay, fine. So
mm-hmm.
how long does he have to be here? They
mm-hmm.
said we'll keep checking.
Mm-hmm.
So of course we stayed for a while.
Mm-hmm.
He had jaundice after that.
Oh my.
Then he was having a lot of gastro issues.
Yes.
And this is one of the telltale signs that no one tells you. Jaundice,
oh, uh-huh.
gastro issues. That
yes.
is stomach issues
yes.
where kids are having a lot of colic
yes.
and reflux
yes.
and stuff
yes.
like
yes.
that.
Yes.
Those are first, the very first signs of autistic characteristics
of
that we
course.
Should be aware of.
Of course.
And I think even the system should be able to teach our nurses
true.
That they look out for this. And at least when you're going to the doctors,
yes.
it's marked like follow up with caution.
Exactly.
You know?
Yeah, because especially with jaundice, and I
yeah.
know this because my firstborn got it,
mm-hmm.
And I was reading, nobody was telling me in the hospital
anything.
What's going
yeah,
on.
Yeah, they just tell you, mweke kwa jua.
Right.
You
or,
know?
You know, eventually they put him under the
UV light.
UV light.
Yeah.
You can't, it's horrific. And then when you hear of the final consequences, you know, which is brain damage,
yes.
it's actually quite scary. And
it
I
is.
Agree, they should
it
continue.
Yeah.
Okay, so here you are, your baby is in
yes.
incubator.
So we were in and out of hospital for like the longest.
Oh
then
my.
One day,
mm-hmm.
When I'm holding the baby,
mm-hmm.
he's dressed. We were just chilling at home.
Yes.
And he starts shaking. And like it wasn't
like
the first
seizures?
Time. Like shaking. Like
yeah.
you know the way when you're feeling cold,
yes.
you're
yes.
shivering. It's a
yes.
tiny baby. I'm like,
oh.
okay, this is what. So when I went for the gastro check, because
uh-huh.
now he was lactose intolerant,
oh,
I had
no.
to stop taking milk.
Oh yes, yes,
I
yes.
had, you know, there are all these new things.
Uh-huh.
And then now you're put on special like what is that thing called? The expensive
the
canned milk.
Oh, the formula?
Yes, formula.
Yes,
yes,
yes.
So it's a very specific formula
okay.
you have to give them.
Okay, for the baby because
the baby
of the complications
now, yeah,
he had.
Of the complications. Because you're
okay.
trying this, you're trying that. And of
right.
course, with all this as a mother, it stresses you. Of course,
yes.
your milk production will not be the same
yes.
and stuff like
mm-hmm.
that. So one day it really went. When I mentioned it to the gastroenterologist,
mm-hmm.
he's like, no, it could be a habit.
Mm-hmm.
It will stop. I'm like, habits. Like, kids have habits, what? You know? Uh-huh. So I'm like, okay, sawa. Uh-huh. Then one fine day when he was around 5-6 months, mm-hmm. he gets a full-blown convulsion, you know?
No.
Like, all body shaking, his eyes roll back. You know, all you can do as a mother is scream, try to figure out. You don't know what to do with this tiny thing.
Yes.
I thought my child had died, was dying.
Yes.
Because that's how it looks like.
Yeah.
And, you know, the thing with convulsions is mm-hmm. no matter how many times you see it, it's
you can never get used to it.
Same pain of the first time.
Yes.
Because you don't know how bad, you don't know how much side effect, you have no idea.
Yes.
This is a child who was meeting his milestone. I know his neck, because I remember one day my dad was like, hey, his neck is a bit, you know.
Mm. It's not as strong.
And you know, we don't like being told such things.
True. Ah, and it's scary.
I'm
anyway.
Like, what are you talking about?
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
So I was like, no, he's fine. You, mm-hmm. you're seeing your own things.
Yes.
So, but he caught up. But then uh-huh. after this seizure, mm-hmm. you know, the way they start mad, they mm-hmm. start crawling.
Right.
We lost everything. So I went back to zero.
Uh-huh.
All the milestones he had achieved, nothing.
No.
So that's when I'm being told, you know, you leave the hospital with like a list of tests
that have
to be done.
Yes.
And you're like, what is going on in my life?
Mm-hmm. So just to take you back, baby mm-hmm. is 5 months old
this is
at this
five,
point.
Six
okay,
months, yes,
okay.
Around 6 months. So we start, first of all, that's finances, because I don't remember, I don't think I had a medical cover
right.
at the time. Mm-hmm. So you're thinking, you're looking at ECG, you know, all those things, you've never CT scan, MRI, and you're thinking, 15,000, 10,000, whatnot.
Yes.
And you're thinking the way you're earning bare minimum at the time, mm-hmm. and it's not going to work.
Yes.
So anyway, I'm very, very glad. I was working at Elite Prepress mm-hmm. at the time, mm-hmm. and my bosses, we were like a family, you know.
That's
so I was
nice.
Like, okay, I'll need to do an advance. Because remember, it was a CS I didn't plan for.
True.
So that means it takes you back to zero, you know.
Yes.
So by the time you catch up, to settle in. And these are some of the strains that these medical conditions bring in life that we never foresee.
Yes.
And we don't see the effects until maybe way later.
Absolutely.
So we went, I remember after the day before I went to take the test, I'm like, I'm not feeling quite okay. And my pills have not come. And I'm like, let me check. And I'm like, you're told, you're pregnant.
No.
And I'm like, you're what? Who?
No way.
You know, I'm like, no, I'm not ready for this. Not in the things I'm handling.
Yes.
God, this cannot happen.
Oh my.
You know?
Look at that.
I was like, no, you can't do this. You know that time you're having that
You're trying to
like,
negotiate with God.
Me,
like,
you know?
Like how?
Like, really?
Now?
Yes. You know, all I'm dealing with, this I can't handle.
And at this point, you've not even figured out
I've
what's
going on.
I've
not even figured out. Yeah.
Yes.
So I remember that during the day now when we went, I have a very special photo of Andrew seated on top of a car and mm-hmm. I'm looking at him like, mm-hmm. how can he be this cute and have all these issues? You know, like a small bundle of beauty with so much issues.
Yes.
So they refused for me, of course, to go in because I was pain.
Yes.
So he had to go in.
Yes.
I was just watching him being put in that MRI tube.
It's quite scary.
It breaks your heart.
Yes.
First of all, sedating him. Because you see, they have high tolerance for a lot of things.
Exactly.
Yeah?
Yes.
So they can control things beyond normal human capability.
True.
So they're trying to put him down. Dude is not going down.
No way.
He's not.
No. And you know, because so obviously in the MRI machine, he's not supposed to
be
moving.
He's not supposed to move.
So they have to. What?
Yes. So they had to like up the doors until he knocked off.
No.
And even when he was there, they had to go and top up again because he started moving. Yes. He's been
what?
A fighter, man. He's
yes,
like
that's
fighter.
A fighter.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
So we finished that, then it comes out, apparently he had a sclerosis in his head.
Okay.
And there's some liquid that wasn't enough in the brain.
Okay. Could you explain to us what that is?
A sclerosis is like a scar.
Oh, I see.
You know, when someone tells you that, the same way you reacted,
like,
I'm like,
what? Just say he has a scar.
Yeah, then they're like, a sclerosis is like a scar. Mm-hmm. And you know, it's not a lot. Maybe over time it will go. Mm-hmm. And for the liquid that we're seeing, maybe it will regenerate. Let's give him time. So they were like, okay, so these are the reasons why he's getting the convulsions. Well, like, okay, so he's going to be put on medicine for the next at least bare minimum 5 years.
No.
Yes.
Wow.
So this is news you process.
Yes.
You process.
Yes.
You process with your partner.
Yes.
Then you think of how you're going to tell everyone else.
Absolutely. And then there's another little
then
one.
Then now there is another story. Now after that you're being told, now you have to stop breastfeeding this one. I'm thinking, I've just been told he has what not. You're telling me to stop breastfeeding. You know, you're losing that contact. I feel like someone is taking him away from me.
Yes.
And anyway, I was like, I have to do what I have to do. Mm-hmm. But the sad thing is, from there, it was downhill, depression.
Oh, of course.
Because I had lost a baby between the two.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I just got a blighted over between my firstborn and my second.
Okay.
So I was like, God, this can't, like so you can't do this to me.
Yes,
you know, at that time, there's so many things that go through your
mind.
So I'm like, another child. I went and told my mom, I can't. I'm sorry, but I can't deal.
Yeah.
You know, I told my friend, I want to get rid of this pregnancy.
Yes. Yes.
I can't. You know, in all sincerity, everything that's going on is too much.
Too much.
You know, I went to start with my mom. So I told her mom. Because my mom is like my best friend, has
Bless
always
her.
Been.
Mm-hmm.
I always tell her everything, even now when I'm being hit on. I'm like,
okay.
Hey, I met this guy, you know that BFF. At least I know her. You
that's
know, and
good.
They say, like, that's one person who'll never leave my side.
Yes.
So I told her, Mom, Cecile, I can't. I'm thinking XYZ. And she's like, please don't. You know, I'm kissy. So there is that culture of boys, blah, blah.
Oh.
And now I have two boys.
Yes.
And she's like, you know me, I've always wanted. We only have one boy in our family. I was like, you just get the baby, give me, I'll take care of you. If you can't, if you really feel that way, just carry to term and give me.
Okay.
So I prayed about it and I was like, okay, God, you know why?
Yeah.
And however, I'll do this, but I need you to walk with me.
Yes.
Otherwise, I can't do this on my own. And suddenly, like I mentioned, that's when I had just separated like twice, I think.
No,
we had just gotten back together.
So obviously, during all this time and all this is happening, your marriage is breaking apart.
You're still fighting that battle.
Yes.
So you're really working hard to get things going and you're still dealing with all these things.
Right.
Anyway, I survived through, but at week 35, when I was 5 months, I was just in pain, constant pain. I was put on medication from week, week that. When I was 5 months pregnant.
Okay.
No one could understand. I just had a pain and my doctor was like, I'm doing everything I can. I don't understand what is going on with you.
Yeah.
So I was like, okay, so it got to a point where he's like, chick, I can't pump anything.
Oh, no.
I can't add anymore. And it was intense pain.
Yes. Yes.
You know?
Yes.
So he was like, we gotta get this baby out. So we are waiting week 35. Because I was admitted for like a whole week at Aga Khan.
And this is when baby, you're 20 weeks.
Thereabout.
Not pregnant.
20, no, we're talking about 6 months thereabout. Six, seven now.
Because
I've been put on pain meds for so long.
And it's
they're
not
like, it's not
improving.
Healthy for
this
child.
Yes.
We'll try and manage it. But that's when I discovered ice cream is actually medicine for the lower abdominal pain. Yes.
Mamas at home, now you know. Ice cream. I wish I knew during my time.
Like I used to remember there was a day I told hubby, I want ice cream. It's like midnight. I don't care. Go out there and bring me ice cream. Vanilla to be very precise.
Wow.
Oh, God.
Yes.
Yeah. And actually, he brought it. I saw him survive until when it got to that week 35. And I felt like those ones totally ill. So they admitted me for a week and they said, next week we get this baby out. We're just waiting for time.
Okay.
So like, okay, sour.
So
I set an appointment.
So the actual time would be 35 weeks.
35 when I was admitted 34 until 35.
So another week.
Another week at home.
Yes.
Then I go week 36 on the dot.
Of course, that is when the baby is full term.
Yeah.
And then there's still this other baby at home.
That I'm still dealing.
You're still dealing with.
Medication.
And you still have a toddler.
I still have another. It was a 4-year-old baby
my
at that time.
My goodness.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So I remember I went to hospital around midday, checked in, was reeled in. This time I said, I have to see. I'm not doing this story of going, waking up to see which hours.
No,
I'm seeing everything.
So
they agreed. They're like, to be a bit uncomfortable.
Yes.
So I remember. But then looks like my kids get that Ugumu for me, because even me going down was, you know, like they injected, I was fine, I could hear them cut, you know, the way you feel just movement,
and
just feeling things.
Yes.
Then I had the doctor say, Jesus Christ, and I'm like, okay, what's going on? Then he's like, Sylvia, if we hadn't done this today, y'all would be gone, both of you.
No.
So now that's when they found out what was going on. So apparently, because the kids came so close, remember I had the first CS, this is 6 months, 18 months later.
Yes.
Bare minimum of CS back to back should be 3 years.
Yes, yes.
So my womb was opening. So all the pain, the intensity inside, the child was slowly getting exposed.
No.
Imagine.
Wow,
imagine.
Mama.
So, and he had flown out, he had dealt with a case like that outside, I think in the UK. So I was like, God comes through
when
wave.
He's supposed to.
Exactly.
Yes.
So he was like, I just experienced, I've heard of this when I was out there. Mm-hmm. I'm so glad I did, because we would not have figured it out.
No.
Yes. So they're like, anyway, we said, by that time,
yes.
Nakombe ile shindano, ilisha. I started
pain.
Feeling the pain.
Oh,
so
no.
Of course they had to knock me out.
Oh.
Now. But I'd seen my baby and I was like,
Of course.
Oh, yeah,
yes, yes.
White.
Yes, and very tiny.
And tiny. Yes. He was tiny.
Oh, yes.
It was like 2 kilos.
Oh,
I was like,
dear.
How am I going to deal? You know, they're so cute and tiny. And
yes.
I was like, okay, at least I've seen him.
Yes.
If anything.
Yes.
And then they knocked me out.
Yes.
So I woke up and I was like, first thing, oh, baby, same story. Mm. Incubated. But at least
of
now
course.
I had the experience. So
yes,
I got out slowly.
Yes.
And I didn't react to this sedation as bad as the other
okay.
one. And I went and saw him. He was now in HDU.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, so that was scary.
Yes.
I remember looking at, there was a mother next.
Yes.
Who the next day came and the baby wasn't there.
No.
And you're seeing your child is next there.
Yeah. Yeah.
Have you ever prayed?
Yes.
Their days we pray.
Yeah, yeah.
So every time you go and you look at this tiny human being.
Yeah.
With so many, you know.
Yeah.
Every morning, evening you go and your fingers are crossed.
Yes.
You know, like can we move from HDU to a normal incubation?
Yes.
And
yes.
actually we made it.
Yes.
Because there's this lady I used to meet, the baby was out like when she was like 4 months pregnant and she had to tie the baby and it was so tiny. So that's when you count your own blessings.
Yes.
Because
yes.
I'm like, mine
yes.
made it this far. We
yes.
are good. We are
yes.
good. Like God, you're not you're, we had a deal.
Yes.
I keep it, you take
care yes.
of us.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So anyway, we got out finally, but then now you're leaving, you have this huge bill.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Because insurance is maxed.
Yes.
Or not, because no one plans for high dependency
no.
unit.
No.
No one plans. And for a child to be in HDU at Aga Khan per day,
I don't even want to imagine.
Until today, I still have a debt.
Yes.
My doctor was gracious.
Oh, yeah. God's
I
grace
still
again.
God's grace. He always
yes.
comes through.
Yes.
Anyway, I take my baby home.
Mm-hmm.
I still have my pains.
So
they still can't figure.
Of course.
So the week after that, I'm nursing my CS.
Uh-huh.
I still have to see a nephrologist. I don't
oh,
know what gist,
no.
all the gists you can think about.
Right.
I was seeing. Wow. I go to this video, tells me, fold your leg. Oh, you have appendicitis. So we have to get your appendix out. So back
no.
to theater. Yes.
Oh my.
Back to theater within that week.
Mm-hmm. Don't go too far. This incredible story continues right after this break.